people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, today I'm going to talk about a new trend that the 87s have developed. Well, it's not new. It's not like it was recently invented, but it seemed to be getting more and more commonplace. So I'm just putting this video out there because it's popped up on social media lately. A number of drivers have started to report some strange occurrences. And then when they reported it to the police basically said, yeah man, these things have been happening for a while now. And when I saw that, I thought to myself then, why isn't the police loudly announcing this to the public? So seeing that there's no official release, right, I'm going to put this video out because maybe, just maybe, even one person can end up avoid falling into this trap. So what is this trick, you may be asking yourself? Now, this is what them do. Them look out for a vehicle that's usually on some lonely road by itself. Right, them not go do it in the middle of half a tree or a crossroad or a content spring or maybe a hip strip or something like that. Right, so they're looking for a driver who's alone, and knowing how 87s think, they probably are look for a female, right? Because you know them love takes it my woman, because they're in their mind they're thinking this is an easier target, right? So what them do, them throw a stone from a distance and lick out your car glass, right? So you're driving down the road, all of a sudden, boom, car glass lick out. Now, your natural instinct as a driver is to stop and see what caused your glass to lick out, right? That's just natural. You're thinking, who lick out my glass? So a lot of people stop, come out of them car, and when they come out of the car, 87 juke them down and rob them. People, it's just that the 87s come like some organisms where no care what you think you'll get rid of them, they must evolve and adapt a new strategy, right? So when people come out of them care to inquire what gone, right, them drip down the people them and gone. So now the people them go to the police station and report, say somebody lit my car glass, and when time look, I'm gonna try to drip me down. Police are gonna say, oh, you know, so we've been getting these reports, because I was reading the post in the greener, right? The police are saying, oh yeah, we've been getting several reports about this. Okay, so why are you not making it public? Why are you not announcing to the public that this is a new strategy? Because as I said, your natural instinct is if you stop the car and come out of the car, right? And you know Jamaicans, you love them car already, because for a man seeing car glass get leak out, him jump out ready for fight long time, because he want no one go on, right? So people, if you drive down a lonely road and out of nowhere your car glass just get leak out, I know so everybody love them car, right? I know so people have only put money in them car, and yes, car expensive to fix, but guess what? Car glass can buy back. Your life can buy back. Insurance can fix car. Insurance can fix life. So nobody jump out on a car down in a lane, in a lonely lane, boy, you take out your ratchet and ready for go fight, man, flick out your car glass. Let's go on about in the business, people. Please, it's not worth it, right? Because guarantee you the stone never fall from heaven as somebody fling it. And there's a bigger plan and a bigger strategy, right? And I guarantee you, even if you jump out of your car with something, let's say, for example, you're armed, that not good enough. So just go on where I go, right? Don't end up in a foolishness, don't end up losing your life, see a kind of car glass. And a matter of fact, this strategy, you know, the reason why I say this strategy is not brand new, because the stone one might be new, where them fling the stone, right, and lick out the glass. But the other one with them use, that I know they've been using this for a while, I think, a matter of fact, quite a few high profile people, including certain dons, one don in particular, end up getting caught with this strategy, where people drive up behind you, bump in your car, right, with them car, or, well, usually it's a car with them not care about, probably a stolen car, or, you know, one of them car with them dispose of, bump in your car, pass some lonely road. Obviously, what are you going to do next? You are thinking, oh, that man I run at the back of my car, so you pull over, ready for go have a long conversation, reach in your glove box, boy, you take out papers, and next thing you look and see, man reach in a film glove box and pick out my machine. Right? So that is the other one. That is the one I know about, the bump into vehicle one. Now that one is tricky because, for example, you are driving down the road and somebody bump into the back of your car. Right? Now, the decision you're thinking to yourself, and I don't remind the people, the scenario we're talking about is you drive down some lonely road. I don't even have to be lonely road because remember I said, they get wet up in a broad daylight, right? But you're driving and somebody bumping in the back of the car. You're going to think to yourself, yo, somebody bumping in my car. So obviously, the right thing to do, a matter of fact, the legal thing to do, is to come out, exchange papers, and file a report. But then, all you know is not somebody that tried to set you up. You see the predicaments where people end up in Jamaica, people? The streets are so messy right now. The streets are so rough that people end up in some situations where they don't even know whether to do the right thing. Because the right thing is to stop. Somebody bumping in your back of your car, you stop. Right? But based on how Jamaica run, people don't even know if they can just drive off. So you drive off and it's not at 87 that try to do something. And then technically that's against the law. Because I mean somebody can correct me, but if you have an accident and you don't report it within a certain time, I think that's against the law. Right? But then the other hand is, alright, yes, alright, let me jump out of the car where you are going, and next thing you know, is a couple of 87s who have been sent to deal with a case or even just to a random robbery. Right? So the streets are set up a certain way now, where people are confused. You don't know whether to do the right thing, because doing the right thing might end up be the last thing you ever do. Doing the right thing might be the difference between you going home to see your family and you end up on a dovecot, right? Or end up over mid arrest under red dirt, right? So, I don't know, people. I don't know. There's a lot of uncertainty surrounding Jamaica, and 87s know this, right? Because when people know, say, all right, I'm supposed to do this, then all the 87 have to do is play on that. All they have to do is align their strategies that fit into you knowing, say, you're supposed to do this, right? As I said, people, they're like some organisms that just refuse to go away, right? So, you know, it come like, you ever sick at people and you feel like you get better, and you say, oh man, yeah man, look like the flu are going now. Next thing you know, you're back sitting again. That's how 87s are, people, right? But I think the police will need to work on the communication side of it. If once you see 2 to 3 incidents happen within a short space of time, at that point, the police need to go loud onto the public and make them know, say, hey, everybody, look over here, say, yeah. The mama show carry glass and I rob people. Don't stop on a lonely road if you carry glass smash out. And I know some people might think, well, Sir P, that's common sense. No, it's not. It's not common sense. Right? Just like if somebody bumping at the back of your car when you drive away business, it's not common sense if you drive one. It's not. The natural thing to do is to inquire and see how I go on. Right? If you see how I can fit, first of all, if you're just driving on something like a car glass, at the time, you might not even realize it's a stone. You might have wondered to yourself, so where you run up, you know, or where you lick. So it's just natural for you to inquire, right? So we can't say, oh, it's common sense, right? Because especially if somebody, let's say for example, some people who left Jamaica 19 or long and come back, right? Remember, if you left Jamaica back in the day, if you left Jamaica in the 80s and early 90s and them time, remind the people, those 87s are not the same 87s that they were now, you know. As I said, 87s adapt. So the strategies them when you are looking for the 90s, when you left Jamaica, will not be the same strategies that you will be coming across in 2020, right? Especially if you never live in our community where you had to deal with this. Because some people left Jamaica when them community did good, you know. Some people left Jamaica in the 90s, right? 80s, 90s, early 2000s, when the community where them left, right? Them could have, if somebody come in your yard at night time, come knock, it was somebody that come check you. It was somebody that come bring you one Christmas cake with them bake, and them say, hey, sister me, the bake you want Christmas cake, you know, somebody give you a piece, right? That's probably what them used to, right? Them no know say nowadays in 2020, if man come knock your yard gate after certain hours, you better lie down in and go like you're asleep, right? So, people, just please, be aware, stay upon on your toes, right? I'm just putting this out there because I didn't hear anything publicly, I didn't see anything on the TV or the major any papers of the headline, because this is something that you can't be in a local back page, because I saw the story in the back page of the Gleaner. You know the little story they were talking at the corner? This thing needs to be front page. This thing needs to be loud. Just like when police are all about them pay them load. I mean, tell them I call up when the ranking officers them are trace with the officers them it load. I see me so want to see them things are load, right? Because these things might be different between somebody, as me say, going on to them family or end up doing a murderous. Right, so Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.